Super fast wireless charging, 10x zoom. While new premium flagship offers more of everything, but should you spend €1,400 on the phone without Google services, hey, enjoy watching that about a month ago probably announces 2020 flagship just like Apple and Samsung this year their Pro. This now also a new higher end P40 Pro Plus. Until the thinking behind this is so that they could off without forcing other users to pay for the premium if those are not features that they really sell. What extra features are on the P40 Pro Plus your life that your kind of think skaters? Subscribe and help us get to our next goal of 1 million subscribers. Only I'd say stick with us and watch the entire video here for an answer to one question in particular, and that's okay also. So this time around work adding you can use supercharged adapter USB agency cable and a pair. From this angle the P40 Pro and Pro Plus look very similar. I like the S20 Plus and its big brother the S20 ear case fits the P40 Pro Plus. The Pro Plus however is thicker and heavier and its camera module is larger given its much more complex camera system. We'll dive more to that later, or you can jump ahead by clicking the chapter marker over here on the outside. The biggest difference between the two is the choice of build material. The 40 Pro Plus is made of ceramic instead of glass material that shouldn't scratch as easily. It's available in black or white. I chose the white model because it doesn't reveal smudges as much as the black phone with my buddy Aaron talked about in his 40W wireless charging. Otherwise it's the same phone, while his most recent carry 995G processor and 8GB of RAM, a 6.58-inch OLED display with a 2640x1200 resolution, and a click over to watch our exhaustive hands-on video. While I did say that I like this size is better even with the added thickness, you're not getting a bigger battery on the P40 Pro Plus. It shares the same 4200mAh battery as the P40 Pro, and in my time using the phone it lasted just as long, about a day and one half on a single charge. That said, it does get one new feature, support for 41 wireless supercharging, which will deliver charging speeds that are as fast as if you were undid by guests, over 50% in 30 minutes, 90% after an hour, and 100% in 1 hour 25. This be the first video on YouTube where you actually see the quality supercharged 40W mileage charge. Instead let's take own, because the fat is really the optional wireless charging stand will cost you extra. I think it should have just come the box. VP40 Pro Plus has 5 rear camera, a 50 megapixel wide angle city camera, a 40 megapixel cultural wide angle camera, a 3D depth sensing camera, a telephoto camera with 3x optical zoom, and a second telephoto camera with 10x optical zoom. That's the most I seen on a smartphone today. Previously the record was 5x, like on Periscope, to see what's inside. But what do you want better? By showing you this cross section of the light is bounced through 5 different mirrors. It's amazing how much they were able to squeeze into this small phone, which also makes me think shouldn't complain about this big camera. But still, you really need this much zoom on a smartphone? Lead maybe not, but I can think of a few examples where that extra zoom come in handy. Empire State Building from across the river, I'm sure I would also love this much zoom. That zoom so that I can get really close to the animal. But even if you were just walking down the street and see a cool kitty cat and want to take a photo without scaring it away, zoom is great for that. Also we're comparing versus the S20 Ultra, 10x will always trump 5x. A perfect example always combined make for a much better, sharper and more detailed photo is another one of a gothic church shot from a block away. Moldings to the textures of the chip paint to the green wire P40 Pro Plus low light performance. It's worth pointing out that both the telephoto lenses do not have the same large sensors and wide apertures like to find on both the ultra wide and camera. Low light performance is not going to be as good. That also means that my phone still works and does a decent job. The less Satan this shot of the Empire State Building after dark, and here's a comparison taken with the S20 Ultra. Isn't the first time I've seen two zoom lenses on one article. I think it's a good idea. Huawei wants to keep pushing the boundaries of optical zoom on phone, in this case from 5x to 10x way, so that a 3x zoom lens for everyday use. I will argue that to it zoom like on the iPhone 11 Pro Max is the sweet spot, and explain, you're at a cafe in a restaurant or so close to New York. So imagine my living room is the cafe. Now there, like me, you might find yourself sitting at a table wanting to snap a photo of your iced coffee for the grant. 2x makes sense both in terms of the perfect distance to shoot the photo and what you're able to fit into the frame, isn't so bad. A little bit tighter, but it still works. Fact, like this photo shot from a different angle, but imagine 5x, that's too close for it to work in this nit space zoom. Plastering it all over the back of the truck, because let's face it, images shot 100x are never going to be good enough to post online unless and how managed to capture a viral moment, or if you're trying to spy on your neighbors, which you shouldn't be doing in the first place. All that said, those who like to take a lot of photos on her phone will enjoy the flexibility Pro Plus offers, especially when it comes to zoom. My one suggestion is that they improve the software experience, making it easier to select the different zoom options. I took the subway for the first time in a long time the other day. Wider field of view on the S20 Ultra delivers a more dramatic image, as can be seen in these photos taken with my S20 Ultra, and then take a look at that same shot taken with the older wide angle camera of the P40 Pro Plus. As you can see, it's not wide enough. There are a few new eye-based software features thrown in, like being able to remove passersby. Let me know what you think. The shooting this with the quality phone, and we're shooting this with the Samsung Galaxy S20 Ultra. Change the lighting conditions to let me know which shot is better. Of course, it goes without saying that low light photo performance is top notch. Even without night, most of the P40 Pro and P40 Pro Plus deliver excellent photos at night. I wouldn't or sunset. Everything looked great during preview when the phone look at software magic brightened. The photo still is great when just not what I was going for. The same applies during the day. Selfie phone today, because I like the way I think that, because of the focal range and the way it doesn't aggressively highlight all my perfection. For a wrap up, it's time for some fire Q&A where I answered some of the questions you left me on social media. How the user experience without its detail, because Huawei phones are best known for the impressive low light performance, it's worth pointing out that both telephoto lenses do not have the same large sensors and wide apertures like to find on both the ultra wide and camera. Low light performance is not going to be as good. That also means that night we are trying to use 10x zoom image will look rather dark in the preview. The good news is that my phone still works and does a decent job. The less Satan this shot of the Empire State Building after dark, and here's a comparison taken with the S20 Ultra. Is another photo taken in my bathroom with very little available. Like, actually, now that I think about it, when it's really dark out I would use the 10x zoom lens without mode turned on. The 10x, this is the first time I've seen two zoom lenses on one article. I think it's a good idea. Huawei wants to keep pushing the boundaries of optical zoom on phone, in this case from 5x to 10x way, so that a 3x zoom lens for everyday use. I will argue that to it zoom like on the iPhone 11 Pro Max is the sweet spot, and explain, you're at a cafe in a restaurant or so close to New York, so imagine my living room is the cafe. Now there, like me, you might find yourself sitting at a table wanting to snap a photo of your iced coffee for the grant. Two times makes sense, both in terms of the perfect distance to shoot the photo and what you're able to fit into the frame. Isn't so bad. A little bit tighter, but it still works. Fact, like this photo shot from a different angle, but imagine 5x, that's too close for it to work in this particular scenario. I also want to take the opportunity to address zooming in as close as possible. OCP 40 Pro Plus and the S20 Ultra allow you to visually zoom up to 100x photo mode. While it is wise not to talk of this feature like Samsung that branding it space zoom, plastering it all over the back of the truck, because let's face it, images shot 100x are never going to be good enough to post online unless and how managed to capture a viral moment, or if you're trying to spy on your neighbors, which you shouldn't be doing in the first place. All that said, those who like to take a lot of photos on her phone will enjoy the flexibility Pro Plus offers, especially when it comes to zoom. My one suggestion is that they improve the software experience, making it easier to select the different zoom option like Samsung that the dispatch here to get a few preset options. Already published a 50-minute video on the P40 Pro and not going to be spending a lot of time talking about the phone's camera. Suffice to say, they are still some of the best, if not the best, in the market today. Take a look at more sample shots he took around the Brooklyn. I will say that I would love it if the older wide-angle lens wider. I took the subway for the first time in a long time the other day. Wider field of view on the S20 Ultra delivers a more dramatic imagine this scene, or better yet, let's take this example from my buddy Michael Fisher's video phone. He didn't invite me to go on that photo walk with him, simply steer his idea. inconvenience but not a deal breaker. Between the App Gallery, Amazon App Store and a Park Pure, able to get most of the apps I need. If you want a lengthier answer and point, link my Make 6S review up here and in the description below. Can you get you to not buy an app that usually works in a browser? Rose or broke, want to see you like that? I can grow and even if I wanted to, but here's a rendering from one faith that was still a thing. Okay, time to bring it. It is the quality P40 Pro Plus you're at if you're looking for the best camera on a smartphone today. P40 Pro Plus is your best bet. From awesome selfies, this is solid daytime photos, to unmatched low light performance, being able to zoom in the furthest, P40 Pro Plus is an all around. But you need to ask yourself, am I willing to live in convenience of not having people play services out of? The answer is yes, go right ahead. But is the €400 premium of the Pro Plus over the Pro model, or that I personally think that the P40 Pro is a better value? Even if an Apple and a 512 GB 11 Pro Max will cost you about the say that said 10 times. Optical zoom is something you can't find anywhere else, and super fast wireless charging is an offering only a handful of phones can manage, and that's what this phone is all about. Like quality's foldable Make success, it's a showcase of all the amazing taxi company is capable of, a foretaste of what might eventually trickle down to other models in about 6 months to a year, and a slice of what Americans are missing because of this betrayed. And that was our quality P40 Pro Plus review. You like videos just like this one, make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel.